In this video, we are going to see about the relative addressing mode. Here, the relative addressing mode, when I say, for example, now let us consider this is a application and we have written some programs. Okay, at some point of time, imagine, so for example, this is location 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. Okay. Now there is some jump statement. Jump to or some go to. Just imagine some go to statement. Go to some label. And that label may be here. Location 6. Okay. Based on some conditions, we are asking you to go to this. These lines will be skipped. So go to 6 means it has to go here, okay, to this memory location. So whatever may be the program counter is pointing, now the program counter is pointing here. So now after this, it will jump here. Immediately it is jumping. So that location is also given there. So that value will be added with the program counter, and now the program counter is pointing to this. So mostly this will be used for memory based on some condition when you want to change the sequence of thing, not only for that, displacement. So for example, here add PC related, this is an instruction, add 25. Means this 25 value is added with the program counter. And when you add, now it is 2075. It goes to that memory locations and that data will be placed in accumulator. Whatever may be the previous value of accumulator, that value is added with 191 and it is replaced in accumulator. So relative addressing mode, which is nothing but program counter value is added with the address part of the instruction, and then it will go to the particular memory locations, and the data is or the instruction is fetched from that. That is what relative addressing mode. Now the next one is indexed addressing mode. This is mostly used while you are using an array part. So here in opcode, the index register content also will be there, and this is an address part. So this will be added with address part. So for example, if it is 4005 and you are referring the location, say for example, if it is 400, let us imagine we have the starting is 400. Okay, I want to address this location. Then address part will consist of what? Right? Now 40, this will be added, this register, and this will be added. The 4001, now it moves to the next. Now I'm accessing the fifth array, the value of the array, fifth position of array means base is this, index base is this. So with this, it will be like this. So 5 will be added, and now it goes here. So this is called indexed addressing mode, and it is mostly used for array manipulations and where some iterations are taking place. Repeated for that also, you can go for this indexed addressing mode is used. The previous one, this relative addressing mode, it is not used explicitly. It is used by the microprocessor implicitly for while it is executing the program, depending upon the instructions in that particular program, it will take the decision whether it has to, based on the say, any conditional jump or something like that, it will move to that. So that program counter value will be added with the address part, and then it will move to the respective position depending upon the instructions in the program. So this relative addressing mode is mostly it is an implied one. Relative addressing mode is not explicitly available to the user. Just like in the previous mode, what we have seen, add R1, R2, like that. Here explicit instructions are there, but here it is not there. The CPU will automatically add the program counter value with the address part and fetch the go to the particular location and fetch the data which is given there. Index addressing mode also, index is given and the address part is given. Here, say for example, I want to access the in the array fifth position, like the sixth position, then that value will be given and the base. The array starts from 4000 to 4005 means the base is given. If I want to access the third, this value, then here 3 is given, 4000 plus 3, it is 4003. Then this is also used by the CPU in order to get the data. And it is mostly used in iterative tasks.